Hello, manifestors. Today we are going to talk about something very, very important, which is to stop chasing your desire. Because I see a lot of you chasing after that desire, and that very chasing that you're doing is keeping your desire away from you. So I am going to do my best to explain to you what you're doing and what to do in order to stop doing it and get that thing already, that desire that you want so much. And please don't forget to like the video, share the video, comment, and subscribe if you have not yet, so my channel can grow and more people like you can wake up to the law of assumption and be and have anything that they want. So I was thinking to make this video because, for one thing, I have noticed how so many of you are struggling with your desires. And also, I have a client who actually has now fully understood what it means to be in the Sabbath, what it means to know that her desire is hers. And she asked me if her feeling was normal, if it was okay to feel this way. And I said that yes, indeed, it's more than okay to feel this way. And then I asked her if I could share what she shared with me. And she said, yes, please do, because few people know and few coaches are explaining this part of manifesting. And I think that the reason why, if it's true that few coaches are explaining this part of manifesting, it's because it can happen differently for different people, even for the same person on different desires. But the thing is, I wanted to explain to you how you should feel, regardless of who you are and what you are manifesting, when you are manifesting a desire. So I'm going to read to you the message she sent me. And again, like I did in the last video, I'm so fortunate I have all those people wanting to share their experiences with you guys, so we can advance in the knowledge of the law of assumption, right? So I'm going to read what she said and we are going to discuss it. I'm going to show you what it is when you're chasing after a desire, what you are really doing when you're doing this, and what you should be doing instead. So here is a short email, but man, how powerful. Hi, Sylvian. I believe I've arrived to where I need to be. I don't obsess over the manifestation as much. When I think of him as my partner, always around. We do things together, we spend quality time together. I even imagine him talking to my pregnant belly. He's already apologized for his action, and he's doing everything in his will to make it up to me. I don't feel the need to do techniques. They feel pointless. I even started preparing for his arrival. I accept the 3D as the past, and he's on his way in. This feeling is relaxed. At first, I felt weird because I felt like I was doing something wrong. Is this what I should expect? Then this is what I replied to her. Yes, that's perfect. You got it. That's what it feels when you live in the end of your wish fulfilled. When you are in your Sabbath, it's done. Congratulations. Keep up with the state. And then she replied again, saying, thanks for the feedback. I am now at a point of indifference. When I think about the manifestation, it's almost as if I don't care as much. Is it normal? I've even moved on to doing other things. YouTube videos are annoying now, lol. this extra time energy feels different. I have a feeling it's coming. Is this the Sabbath? Yes, indeed, guys. This feeling of knowing, of even feeling like you don't even really want this thing anymore, is the feeling of the Sabbath, is the feeling of knowing that your desire is yours and that you have nothing to do anymore. On the other hand, I see a lot of you, after weeks and weeks and, God forbid, months, you still have the feeling that you have to do something. So you keep on doing those sets. You keep on doing affirmations. And when I say affirmations, I'm talking about those specific desire affirmations, SP affirmations. Affirmations that you say in order to get something. Not the affirmations that are meant to control your self-concept and to replace your negative thoughts. I'm not talking about those affirmations. I'm talking about the affirmations that you keep on repeating in order to convince yourself that your desire is yours. Like, SP is mine, SP is mine, SP is mine, you know? This type of affirmations. Because let's get to the point here. Most of you who are struggling, it's when you're trying to manifest a specific person, which is by far the most resistant type of desire that anyone can have. It's worse than money, it's worse than health, it's worse than anything else. That specific person, it's awful. The way you guys, this attachment that you have, this powerlessness that you have, this whatever you're doing, it's absolutely terrible, all right? Because what you are doing is the complete opposite of what this person right now is feeling. You are so attached to it. You feel so separate from that state of being in a relationship with that person that you always, always feel that you have to do something. When the only thing that you have to do really is to keep on working on your self-concept. That you still have to do, my dear friends. And especially if you're still chasing after that SP of yours, it means that you still have some work to do on your own self. So that's the thing that you really have to do. And the second thing that you have to do is to assume, to feel that your desire is already yours. Now, one might ask, how do I assume? How do I feel that state of having my desire? Well, you get there by, again, working on your concept of self. Because if you have a low concept of self, it's going to be harder for you to be able to assume that whatever desire is yours. That's number one. And number two is work on yourself. Work on your inner growth. Work on your spirituality. The best way to work on that is to meditate. Now, when I say meditating, I do not mean you doing some specific rule type meditation that takes forever to get good at and that takes 2 hours a day. I'm not talking about this type of meditation. Meditation is simply closing your eyes and dwell into the silence a little bit. Detach from the 3D world, from the noise, from the needs, from the attachments. That's the type of meditation I'm talking about. And you detach from your thoughts. You just observe your thoughts. You're going to have thoughts, but just let them come and go. Just don't judge the thoughts. Just observe them coming in and coming out. You can also silently say in your mind, I am. Don't say anything after the I am. Just repeat slowly and silently, I am. Until you feel very calm, very centered. If you do this just once or twice, nothing is going to happen. Nothing is going to change. But it's when you do this repeatedly, every day, for a while, you are going to start seeing a change in you. You are going to start shifting. You are going to level up your I am-ness, your consciousness, your awareness. Because what I notice in a lot of you running after this SP of yours is that you feel little. Your ego self is big. Your human self is big. It's huge. That's why you feel so little. Because you need to replace that ego self with more of God self, basically. By the way, if you have not read my last blog post over here, please give it a read. I'll put the link in the description box below this video. I have myself experienced a shift this summer. I felt it. I felt a shift in knowing who I truly am. It's very hard to explain it with words because you cannot explain such a thing with words very well. But I can tell you why it happened. It happened because I have done what I preach, right? I've worked on my self-concept and I still work on it. And I have practiced this type of meditation that I'm telling you about just 10, 15 minutes a day, every single day for a while. And this helped me to feel that I always have been there and that I will always be there. And that my desires, big or small, have always been there for me. They are already here. And I have experienced lately how things are really happening so very fast. Every time I have a thought these days, I have a thought, boom, it manifests. Now, when you feel that you still have to do techniques in order to get your desire, what does that show? What does it show me and what should it show you? It's showing you that you do not have your desire. As long as you are doing a specific technique to get that thing over there, what does it mean? It means that you don't have it. It implies that you don't have your desire. You've got to understand this. So while is it okay to do techniques for a while to impress your subconscious mind? If your subconscious mind is still not impressed after weeks and weeks and months, you are only confirming that you do not have it. I'm doing such and such technique because I don't have my desire. Therefore, I need to do more techniques. Let me do one more affirmation here. Let me do one more sat there. After a while, guys, this is only proof that you don't have your desire and that you don't believe that you have it. And that's why you need to do the technique. What happens to this person, however, which allowed me to show her example, is that now she knows that her desire, her SP, is hers. So she feels completely detached from the need. She feels to the point of being indifferent. She doesn't even feel like watching videos anymore. She feels, in other words, above and beyond that by now. Why? Well, because she did the work. She did the work that I told her to do. And she did it very well. She didn't use techniques to get the SP, let's say, but rather use the techniques to embody the feeling, to impress the subconscious mind, to embody the state of having. If you are not doing the techniques for that, by the way, for that purpose and that purpose only, you are still forever going to have to do techniques as a clutch, but that's not what techniques are supposed to be. Techniques are only meant to put you once and for all in the right feeling, in the right state of having your desire. Not to be used as a clutch that you need forever in order to help you to walk straight. That is not how we should use a technique. That is not how we should use an affirmation. That's not how it's done. We use techniques, affirmations, anything you want, in order to impress ourselves. So that thing that we want to feel becomes part of us. The reason, wherever you are right now, whatever you are manifesting, the reason why you don't have your desire is because you are not in the right state. That's the only reason. Just this past week, someone posted in my Facebook group, in the free group, that somehow he had managed to embody the state that he wanted to be in. And in a matter of 20 minutes, he manifested his desire. So guys, I'm not saying that you can manifest anything in 20 minutes. But once, no matter what your desire is, once you embody the state where that desire already exists, it's going to happen very fast. The fastest that the 3D can make it, it's going to happen. All right? So it's not going to take weeks and weeks and weeks and months and years. That's what I'm saying. Once you embody the state where your desire already exists. Do you get that? Do you get what it means? It means that you're not creating anything from scratch or anything like that. It's already there. Not only it's already there, it already exists in a certain state. But you are in a different state where your desire doesn't exist. Let me give you an example. Right now, I am sitting in my office. And let's say I want to see my kitchen sink. And I'm looking here in my office for my kitchen sink all over the place. Where's my kitchen sink? Where is the kitchen sink? I can't find it. Why? Because I'm in the wrong room. I'm in my office. There's no kitchen sink here. What do I need to do to get to the kitchen sink? I need to go to the kitchen. I need to step in another room. If I go to the kitchen, I'm going to see my kitchen sink, right? I hope this helps you to visualize what you're doing with your manifestation, with your desire. As long as you are in the wrong state, so you are in the wrong room, right? You're in the wrong state. You cannot see that desire that exists in the other state, right? As long as I dwell in my office, I cannot see my kitchen sink. I need to go to the kitchen. As long as you dwell in the state of being single, you cannot see that relationship of yours. It's not there. So please stop looking all over the place in your state of being single for that relationship. It doesn't exist in that state. It is not there. You could look for it for 100 or 1,000 years. You would not find it. However, the moment you step in that state where your relationship already exists, you don't have to create it, no more than I have to create my kitchen sink. I don't have to fabricate my kitchen sink. It's already made, right? The moment you step into that state where your relationship exists, your relationship is going to happen very, very fast. You're not going to need me anymore or any other coaches. Do you get that? If you get that, guys, I am so happy for you because this is going to change your world. And what happened to me these past few months is that I already knew that, right? And I already experienced very fast manifesting, very strong assumptions. You all know about that if you know my story, right? But lately, I truly, truly had like I leveled up in the understanding and the feeling of that. That all I have to do, no matter what I want, is to relax, be still, and step in that state of it is done. Or in that reality, whatever you like to, whatever term you like better, it's the same thing. Where my desire exists. All right? And the moment I step in the state, I like the word state better than reality because the word reality can be very confusing for some people. So I prefer to use the word state. The moment you step into that state where your desire already exists, it is there. It's upon you. Now, I know you are going to ask, but how do I step into that state? Well, the best way to step into the state is by letting go of any attachment that you have in this 3D. Any attachment. The attachment of the SP, the attachment for result, the attachment of time, any attachment. You just let go and you let yourself be. Live in the moment more. Because guess what? Manifestors or not, conscious manifestors or not, there's only one time and it's all the same time. It's the now. So whether you are 20 or 80, you have the same time available to you, which is the now. So let go of everything and dig deeper inside you, knowing that you are the beginning and the end, as the Bible says. You are God. You are the beginning and the end. The more you detach from the external and the more you go within, the more you are going to understand with feeling, with experience, what a shift feels like. But you can also use questions to help you find that state where your desire already exists. And I've mentioned that in videos before. Ask yourself questions such as, how would I feel right now if I was what you want to be? How would you see the world? What would you be thinking right now? How would you walk? How would you talk? How would you sit down? How would you hold yourself? By doing those things, meditating more, going more within, detaching more from anything that is 3D, anything and everything, and asking yourself on a regular basis every day, as a matter of fact, right? This type of questions. That's how eventually you are going to understand what it means to shift from one state to the other and to do it consciously. It is not easy to explain with words, guys. I can only try to translate it to you in words, but it's best with experiencing it, right? Once you experience it, then you'll understand it. But hopefully, this video helped you understand what to do and what not to do when it comes to manifesting your desire and getting to that feeling of it is done. You get to that feeling when you release all attachments. And yes, it is part of manifesting, especially what we call big desires, meaning the desires that we really, 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 really want. Going through that detachment, that letting go, that knowing, which is called the Sabbath, is normal. If you are there, don't be scared. Don't be asking me, wow, I don't feel like I really want my SP anymore. Is it normal? Yes, it is. Because when you know that it's yours, you don't even want it as much anymore. That doesn't mean you don't want it anymore. It's just a normal feeling because it's like you already have it. And you do no longer desire what you have. And that's why you have that feeling. All right, guys, I hope this was helpful. I intend that it was. If it was, please give me a thumbs up comment, share the video if you can, and subscribe if you have not yet, because I have plenty of great content still to share. Thank you for listening, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye for now.